Mucchitam,
just get him released.
Just getting released.
Yeshaha, this.
Brahmana,
a Brahmana. Nitaram, our.
Guruhu,
teacher. Translation. She could not tolerate Ashwatthama's being bound by ropes, and being a devoted lady, she said, release him, for he is a Brahmana, our spiritual master.
In the previous verse, it has been described Vamasabhava Vayananamas. Bama Sabhava, Bama, woman, they are very soft-hearted, Bama Sabhava. So, although Ashwatthama killed her sons very mercilessly and he was arrested, and Krishna ordered him be killed, and Arjuna was just preparing to punish him, but Bama Sabhava, woman, being very soft-hearted, without any consideration, she immediately offered her respect, Nanam. Not only she offered her respect to Ashwatthama, being the son of a Brahmana, especially of Dronacharya, their teacher. So, she immediately ordered Arjuna, Mucchatam, release him immediately. You have arrested a Brahmana, Mucchatam, Isha, Brahmana, Nitarang, Guru. Brahman is always our guru. Although he has killed my sons, still he stands to be my guru, your guru. So, this is Vedic culture that they know how to offer respect to the proper person, but Arjuna, he also decided that although Krishna ordered him to kill Ashwatthama, his guru's son, although he is not Brahmana, is Brahma Bandhu. He has been described as Brahma Bandhu, not Brahma. But Draupadi, being woman, Vama Sabhava, very soft-hearted, she did not consider whether he is actually a Brahmana. His son of a Brahmana, that much she knew. This is the difference, how to calculate whether one is Brahmana or not Brahmana. Brahmana and Brahma Bandhu. These two words are there. Just like if you are the son of a high court judge, you can be called, you have got the right, that son of a high court judge. That is all right. But you cannot claim to become the high court judge. That is not true. Unless you are qualified, unless you are actually acting as high court judge, you cannot be called a high court judge. Simply by becoming the son of a high court judge, you cannot become the high court judge. Similarly, simply by becoming the son of a brahmana, you cannot become a brahmana. A woman, Vama Sabhava, she can accept that because he is the son of a brahmana, he is brahmana. Therefore this word is used, Vama Sabhava. Because women are considered less intelligent. In the Bhagavad Gita, their heart is very soft. That's like children. Their heart is very soft. But their intelligence is not very soft. That is the difference. Sriya Sudra Tatha Vaishya. Krishna said, Sriya Sudra Tatha, they have been put in one group. Woman, Vaishya and Sudra. Because they are not very intelligent. They can be molded by another intelligent man to the proper channel. Therefore they require guidance. They require guidance. This morning I was reading about Sita Devi being kidnapped by Ravana. Now, because there was not Ramchandra present and Lakshman was also not present, she was unguarded and Ravana took the opportunity to kidnap her. So, even Sita Devi, she is goddess of fortune. She is the spiritual potency of Lord Ramchandra. She is not ordinary woman, but showing us the example that in Sita Devi, Sita Devi is the original potency. Of course, Ravan could not kidnap Sita Devi as she is. That is not possible. This is described in another Purana, that when Ravana came to kidnap Sita, Sita Devi disappeared from there and she kept a Maya form, false form, and Ravana kidnapped. This is stated in very authoritative scripture. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was traveling in South India, a Brahmana invited him. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu at noontime went there, but he saw the Brahmana has not cooked anything. There was nothing prepared. And he was crying and reading Ramayana. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu inquired, "The Brahmana, why you are in such a depressed condition, you are crying?" And sir, I am so... He was in the ecstasy of Hanuma. "Then I am so unfortunate that Sita Devi has been taken by Ravana and I could not rescue her still." In this way he was puzzled. She did not cook anything. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu pacified him. Then he could understand that I invited. It was done. Then when he was returning, I forget the name of the Purana, Purva Purana, he got evidences that Sita Devi, when she was supposed to be kidnapped by Ravana, a false form was kidnapped. And when Sita Devi was tested, putting her into the fire, she entered into the fire and the Maya Sita was burned and the original Sita came. So it was not possible for Ravana to touch even the lotus feet of Maharaj Sita. But apparently it is externally manifested that Sita was taken away just to teach us that even Sita Devi is the origin of all potencies of the Supreme Personality of God. Chit Shakti, Parasu Shakti, Vividhaiva Sriyate, the Supreme Personality of Godhead has got many potencies, multi-potencies, and one of the potencies is Alladini Shakti, pleasure potency. That pleasure potency is Sita, Radharani, Lakshmi Devi. This has been described by Sarup Damodar Goswami. Radha Krishna Pranaya Vigiti Alladini Shakti Rasma Ekatmanabhapi Deho Bhedo Gatoto. These are described. That the Krishna's pleasure potency, Radharani, is Krishna. But to take pleasure, they become two. Ekatmanabhapi Deho Bhedo Gatoto. They become divided into two, Radha and Krishna. Again, Sri Chaitanya Prakata, when Krishna came as Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the Radha Krishna combined together. Therefore, the devotees of Radha Krishna or Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they worship Sri Krishna Chaitanya Radha Krishna Nahe Anna. They say, this is the fact. Lord Ramchandra is also Krishna. Sita Devi is also expansion of Radharani. They are the same tattva. Ramadi Murti Sikalaniyame Natishthan Naravataram Akarat Bhuvani Sukhintu Krishna Sayang Samabhavak Paramapumanaju Govinda Madhi Purisham Tamam Bhajan. So here the example that even Sita Devi, the direct potency of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, she is showing that without being protected, she she can be ravished, she can be kidnapped, she can be misused by the Rakshasas. This is it. Sita Devi was quite competent, but this is it. Another example is that because Lord Ramchandra took Sita in the forest from moral principle, he should not have taken Sita. Pathe nari vivarje, the moral principle is that when you are going out of home, you should not take your wife with you. Pathe nari vivarje, because there may be so many dangers. That actually happened. Sita Devi, because Lord Ramchandra was ordered to go to the forest, not Sita Devi, neither anyone, neither Lakshmana. They, out of their own affection for Lord Ramchandra, they decided to go with him. But because Sita Devi went with Ramchandra, so many catastrophes happened. She was kidnapped, and there was fight, and the whole dynasty of Ravana was killed, and so many things happened. So, this instruction that Pathe Nari Vivarja. And another lesson is that even Lord Ramchandra, he was attached, naturally, one is attached to his wife. So if we become attached to a woman, then we have to face so many dangers. This is another instruction. Even Lord Ramchandra is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and still he had to accept so many troubles. They were loitering in the forest, feeling the separation of Sita Devi. So many things happened. So, Mama Sabhav, their women are very simple, soft-hearted. The whole idea is they should be given protection, no freedom. That is injunction of the Manusangita. Nasriyam satantatam arhati. Women should not be given freedom. They must be protected. Not that sometimes we receive the complaint in foreign countries, they say that you keep your women like slaves. So I replied, we do not keep our women as slaves. They are very respectful at home. The sons offer their highest respect to the mother. The husband gives the topmost protection to the wife. This is the example. Just like Lord Ramchandra. Lord Ramchandra is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. But Ravana took Sita from his protection. Ramchandra could marry many millions of Sita, or he could create many millions of Sita, but he is showing the example that it is the husband's duty to give protection to the wife at any cost. And he did it. For one woman, he killed the whole Ravana's dynasty. This is husband's duty. So, protection, not slave. It is protection. The husband should give to the wife the topmost protection, and the wife should be so faithful to the husband that Sita Devi, she was king's daughter, Videho Raj. She has a daughter. She was not a poor man's daughter. And Dasarath Maharaj did not ask her to go to the forest with her husband. She could easily say, my dear husband, you are going to the forest. I am king's daughter. I cannot take so much trouble. Better you go. Let me go to my father's house. No. I shall take all the troubles with my husband. This is faithfulness. Similarly, Draupadi. Draupadi also went with the Pandavas in the forest when they were banished. And Kunti Devi also went with their son, with her sons in the forest. This is the system. Kunti Devi had nothing to do with the gambling of Pandavas and Duryodhana. But because the sons were to go to the forest, the mother also followed, and the wife also followed. This is Vedic system. Vedic system. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also had very nice, beautiful wife at home and very affectionate mother. Both personalities are very good asset in family. Chanakya Pandit says that if one hasn't got mother at home and the wife is not very agreeable or not very peaceful, he said, Mata jasya grihe nasti bhajya cha priyavadini arannam te nagantadvam yatharannam tatha griham. He advises, if one has no mother at home and wife is apriyavadini, he talks very roughly, not very nicely, then that person immediately leaves that home and go to the forest. Yatharannam tatha griham. For him, either at home or in the forest, the same thing. Yatharannam tatha griham. So this is Vedic culture. Women should be trained up from the very beginning how to become good wife and good mother. That is the Bhama Sabhava. So here is example. Kunti Devi is one example. Draupadi is one example. We have got many examples how to train women. They are very soft-hearted. They can be molded in any way. And Bhishma Dev has advised, when Bhishma Dev was in the bed of arrows, Sarasajya, so the Pandavas, the Kurus, they took many advices about politics, sociology, many things, religion, king's duty. So many instruction was taken. In that instruction, he also confirmed the Vedic injunction that women should be always protected very carefully. There is one quality of shyness. If you break that shyness of women, it will be very dangerous. It will be very dangerous. That is the one valve to check. So, modern civilization is not strictly following the Vedic injunction. Therefore, especially I have seen in the Western countries, there is no home practically. there is no homely happiness. Because women are allowed to mix freely and there is no protection, they are not married, there is no husband, the father also does not take care. As soon as the girl becomes 15, 16 years, she goes away. Therefore, I have practically seen there is no home, there is no peace in the Western countries. These are very important things that soft-hearted women, bhava sabhava, they should be given protection, they should be trained up how to become faithful wife, affectionate mother, then the home will be very happy. And without happiness, we cannot make any spiritual progress. We must be peaceful. This is the preliminary condition. Therefore, as far as possible, the Vedic injunction is there should be division in the society. Vannasamacharvata, because the whole aim is to reach the Supreme Personality of God, Vishnu. Vishnu aradhati pungsa nanna tattu sukaranam Vannasamacharvata purusena parupuma. Vishnu aradhati. Our only aim should be how to approach Vishnu. Aradhananam sarvesha Vishnu aradhanam param tasmat paratanam devi tadiyanam aradhanam. This is the instruction of Lord Shiva to Parvati. Parvati's question was, which aradhan is the best? He replied, aradhananam sarvesha Vishnu aradhanam param. He said, but the knowledge is there. We have not lost the knowledge, but we have neglected. If we take advantage of this knowledge, then the whole world will become happy. That is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mission. What is mission of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? His mission is, he says, Bharat Bhumite Manusya Janma Hailo Ja Janma Sarthakari Karo Paro Upakar. Anyone who has taken birth on the land of Bharatvarsha, it is Punna Bhumi. And not only Punna Bhumi, not only Lord Ramchandra has appeared here, not only Krishna has appeared here, not only Lord Buddha has appeared, not only Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has appeared, because it is Punya Bhumi. Whenever the Lord appears, He comes on this land, Bharat Bhumite Manusya. Therefore, the human being, not the cats and dogs, must take advantage of this birth on Bharatvarsha and take advantage of the Shastras and make his life successful. Janma sarthak kari karo paropaka. These Indians are not made for exploiting others. Upoka. How people will be advanced in spiritual consciousness? How they will understand the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Vishnu? Because they do not know what is the aim of life. Parabhavastavat abodajat javanna jigyasato atma tattam. We are born all fools and rascals, abodajat, without any sense. So we require education. What is that education? Atma tattam apushyatam atma tattam griheshu griyamedina. If we do not cultivate atma-tattam, then whatever we are doing, we are being defeated. That's all. We are being defeated. Atmatattam. That Atmatattam is the first instruction in the Bhagavad Gita. Dehinasmin yatha dehi, kaumara yogunang jala, tatha dehantara prapti dhirasattva namuji. This is Atma, beginning. Asmin dehi, within this body, there is the soul. Dehinasmin yatha dehi. Not this, body is important. But it's nothing. It is dead matter. When Krishna began his instruction and Arjuna was lamenting on the basis of this body, if we kill our brothers, their wives will be widowed and they will be bhastachar, the Varnashankar will be there, everything he was calculating on the basis of this body. All politics, sociology, they're going on this basis of this body. But Krishna, as soon as he was accepted by Arjuna as Guru, Sishasteham Sadhima Prabhanda. Now, Krishna, I accept you as my Guru, not as friend, because friendly talking is useless waste of time. He accepted as Guru. When Guru speaks, you cannot argue. That is not the process. You should have accepted Guru who is infallible. Otherwise it is useless. He accepted Guru Krishna because Krishna is infallible. If we accept Guru, bogus Guru, then it is no benefit. Guru means Krishna's representative. Guru, not that everyone can be Guru. It is said in the Shastra that sat karma nipuna vipra. Just like here it is accepted, brahmana nitana guru. So, generally, brahmana is accepted as guru by other orders of society. So, the Shastra said, that Brahman is Guru, that's all right. But Sat Karma Nipuna Vipra, one Brahman is very nipun in his karmakandya, knowledge, Sat Karma, Pathan Pathan Jajan Jajan Dan Pratigra, this Sat Karma. Nipuna, very expert, Mantra Tantra Vishara. And he is very expert in chanting the Vedic hymns and execution of tantra and so many things. Avaishnava Guru Nasasya. If he is Avaishnava, if he is not attached with Vishnu, if he does not carry the order of Krishna, Guru Nasasya. Shat Vaishnava Sabacho Guru. But if a person is Vaishnava, even if he is born in the family of a sapacha. Sapacha means dog eater, chanda. If he is a Vaishnava, he can become Guru. And if one is a Brahmana, if he is not a Vaishnava, naturally, Brahmana means Vaishnava. Brahmana means Pandit. Still in India, a Brahmana is addressed as Panditji. Because a Brahmana and Murkha, rascal, this is contradictory. It cannot, unless one is highly learned, unless one has learned what is Brahma, he cannot become Brahmana. So not only one should be Brahmana, but he should become a Vaishnava. Still higher. From Brahmana platform he has to come to the Vaishnava platform. Brahma Bhuta Prasannatma na sochati nakankhati samas sarvesu bhuteshu madbhakti lavate vana. One has to become Brahma Bhuta, that is Brahmana. The sign is na sochati nakankhati. He does not care for anything material. He is always satisfied. on Brahma. That is Brahma. But in spite of this quality, if he does not enter into the bhakti, then he is not a Vaishnava. He may be a Brahmana. This is clearly defined in the Bhagavad Gita. Brahma Bhuta Prasanna Atma na sochati, na kankati, is pacified. Sama sarvesu bhuteshu, he is equal to everyone. Then he is qualified to become a devotee, Vaishnava. So unless he comes to that state, he cannot become guru. Evaṁ parampara prātam evaṁ rāja saivu. So here the Pāṇḍava family, they are very enlightened family, and still Bāma Sabhava, the woman, is soft-hearted. She did not consider about Asatthama's position, but so far Krishna is concerned, Arjuna is concerned, they consider that he is not a Brahmana, but he is a Brahma Bandhu. Brahma Bandhu. Brahma Bandhu means son of a Brahmana, but behavior is something else. He is called Brahma Bandhu. Thank you very much.